guys, Tina Gale here, and I'm so happy to be back with the Scrap Room as their guest designer here in June. And I'm working with their Flavors of the Month kit, and this is the American Crafts Starshine collection that I'm working with today. So this is the second collection that I'm sharing with you. And since I am such a huge fan of Chamel and all of her work, I decided to try to channel my inner Chamel and do a layout similar to what she would create. So she often uses a large block patterned paper and then lots of strips. So I started with a large square in the back and then made a couple of long horizontal pieces, one wider and one narrower, that I notched to make a banner. And then I have 2 4x6 photos, which she also often scrapbooks 4x6 without cropping them down. And I did use some of the paper from the add-on paper kit. This is one from the Photo Play paper, the pink paper. I needed something to mat my photos with, and so I just pulled it out of the add-on kit and backed my photos with it. And then the back of one of the papers from American Crafts had a green and a white striped. And so all I did was trim down the green strips, and I punched them with my border punch. This is the large scalloped, it's an embossed scallop. And this is another border punch that Chamel uses a lot. And it's the reason that I bought it is because I've seen her use it quite a few times and I love the big scalloped. So that was just one more influence from Chamel. So I just punched it and I put it across the bottom, and I wanted it just a little bit longer. So you saw me cut it apart and make two pieces out of it so that I could have it come out on the left-hand side further. And then I had a small strip that I used up at the top to create a cluster up there. And that's something else that Chamel does a lot too, is create a little cluster off of the page at the top on her designs. For this little globe on the embellishment pieces, I cut it from the patterned paper, which is another thing that Chamel does a lot of, is fussy cutting. She uses her paper to the max. I don't think there's another designer out there that gets so much from just patterned paper as Chamel does. And so that's a huge influence on me. I love patterned paper and I buy so much of it. So it's great to use it in unique ways, such as your embellishing, and you know, border punching and doing all of that. So I fussy cut it, I'm going to pop dot it up, and that's going to be my little cluster embellishment start over here. And one of the things that I'm wanting to do on this photo, I knew I wanted my embellishments over here, but these pictures are taken at Disney World, and if you've ever been there or any other place that's a tourist attraction, you know it's hard to get photos without all kinds of people and other things in the photo that you don't necessarily want. So I'm going to cover up some of these people that were walking by with my embellishment cluster. And this twine came in the Flavors of the Month kit. It is part of the embellishments that came with the Echo Park Petticoat and Pinstripe collection. And it matches perfectly with this, so I pulled it over and tied a little bit around the globe just for some added dimension. And then I'm going to also put some up at the top with some staples. So I've covered up the people that I didn't want in my photo. I wanted to really draw attention to my family here. And so I'm also using this arrow, and it says go with all of your heart. So these are photos that we typically take when we go to Disney World. I always seem to get a photo of the three of them underneath the entrance to Tomorrowland here, and my daughter's always, you know, posing and doing something fun, and the guys are just always standing there looking at her like, must we? And so no matter how hard she tries, she can't convince them to have fun and let loose at Disney World too much. And so I always get these really funny shots right here, and I think I've scrapped probably every one of them. So this was one of our more recent trips, probably about 3 trips back. So I wanted to get those done, and I have done several Disney layouts with the Starshine collection. It's just a perfect color scheme, and even the themes and patterns in it and the words that go with it are perfect for Disney. So let's see, I've added my embellishment down there. The flare came in your kit as well as the paper clip, so I just put those in. And then the So Happy is a chipboard embellishment, and the Admit one is also from the chipboard sheet that I received. So if you're working with your kits and you receive different embellishments, just make it work with whatever you have. They all have the chipboard pieces, so just find ones that match with the photos that you're doing. Then this was a branding strip for one of the papers, and I loved that it had all of the colors, and I wanted to put it on there, and I kind of thought I wanted it up at the top, and if I hadn't already stapled and put everything up, I might have went ahead and put it up there. But I decided to just clip it up underneath this paper clip and that piece, and I really liked that because that brought that white up there to the top that's kind of like the banner piece that has all of the text. So that really made that pop up there. And so I was really happy that I found that. And then I just wanted some little smaller embellishments. I have the main clusters done, and so now I just need a little bit of extra. So I went back to the chipboard embellishments, and there were three little yellow stars, and I decided that was perfect. I would put one of those in each one of the three clusters. And then I also had that red chipboard heart that I put with the globe because I needed to repeat the red that was in the other two, so that was perfect. And then all my Disney layouts, if you follow me, I always put a hidden Mickey. And so I punched a Mickey out, and I sit here and I play just about everywhere and putting it in typical places because I usually just tuck it in with an embellishment cluster where it's not real noticeable, but, you know, it's there if you know that I put it in there. And then I just happen to stick it up here and slide it behind that paper clip, and it was perfect. So I end up, I'm going to flip it over here in just a minute to where it's in the dark blue, and put it underneath the paper clip, and it makes that paper clip into a Mickey head. So I just thought that was perfect and love how that turned out. So that's how that's going to stay. And then I just need to add my journaling, and I'm just going to put it on some strips, that sheet of paper that had the green and white stripes, the off-white stripes that was left. I just cut it down and did some journaling strips and put off to the left-hand side. So here are some close-ups. If you're not a subscriber, I would love to have you subscribe to my YouTube channel. Be sure to check out my blog, and I'll have all of the links down below and on my blog as well to the scrap room and the kits for June. So thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you back here real soon with another process video. Bye!